Hello, welcome to Nursing with Professor B. My name is Bridget. I have a master's degree in nursing education. I'm also a family nurse practitioner. In this video, I'll be going over medical abbreviations, the letter H. Medical abbreviations, the letter H. If you see HA, it stands for headache. Even if there's a forward slash here, sometimes they'll do that, like H slash A is still a headache. HAV is hepatitis A virus. Hepatitis A virus is transmitted through the fecal-oral route. Sounds really gross, but if you wipe your butt and don't wash your hands, and you put your hands in your mouth, you can get Hep A. It's transmitted through close person-to-person contact with an infected person, sexual contact with an infected person, use your imagination, or ingestion of a contaminated food or water. For example, if they didn't cook the meat well enough and it had some fecal matter in there, or it wasn't washed properly, you could get Hep A. There is a vaccine for Hep A, by the way, and I was looking at the CDC site, and hepatitis A rates have skyrocketed. In 2017, they've started to increase rapidly. So if you are a frequent traveler or any, consider getting the hepatitis A vaccine. HB stands for hemoglobin, and this is a really nice drawing that I saw that inside of each red blood cell, you have hemoglobin. And hemoglobin is a protein inside of red blood cells that carries oxygen. The red blood cells, by the way, are this concave disc shape. HBV is hepatitis B virus. By the way, according to this test, this person has hepatitis B. And hepatitis B, there's also a vaccine to prevent hepatitis B. And hepatitis B is spread when blood, semen, or other body fluids from an infected person enters the body of someone who's not infected. This can happen through sex, sharing needles, syringes, or other drug injection equipment, or from mother to baby at birth. Symptoms of hepatitis B can include fatigue, poor appetite, stomach pain, nausea, jaundice. HCG is also known as the pregnancy hormone, human chorionic gonadotropin, and it's called the pregnancy hormone because this is what pregnancy tests are looking for. When you dip that pregnancy test in urine, it's checking for the presence of this hormone. It is made by cells formed in the placenta, which nourishes the egg after it's been fertilized. Levels can be detected by a blood test about 11 days after conception and about 12 to 14 days after conception by a urine test. And again, the way I remember, for example, that if a test is positive is it makes two people to make a baby, so two lines means they're pregnant. All right, HCT is hematocrit, and hematocrit is the percentage by volume of how much of your blood contains red blood cells. So everything has to be in balance, right? So normal hematocrit is that this is saying 45%. I got this from labpedia.net. But hematocrit is saying formed elements are about 45%. That's what makes it up, and plasma is about 55%. Poly means too many. So your hematocrit is too high if it's above this percentage. And if it's below, then it indicates that you have anemia. Now, a low hematocrit doesn't only indicate anemia, it can indicate also other conditions. HD could be heart disease, and heart disease is the leading cause of death in the United States, causing about 1 in 4 deaths. You can greatly reduce your risk for heart disease through lifestyle changes, and in some cases, you may need medication. And then HD could also stand for Hodgkin lymphoma, and here you see the swollen lymph node. And Hodgkin's lymphoma is a type of cancer that starts. So cancer, in a nutshell, occurs when cells start to grow out of control. Lymphomas are cancers that start in white blood cells. HGH is human growth hormone, and growth hormone is a small protein that is made by the pituitary gland and is secreted into the bloodstream. Growth hormone essentially regulates growth, metabolism, and body composition. So HNH, hemoglobin and hematocrit, we've gone over hematocrit, we've gone over hemoglobin. Hematocrit, remember, is the percentage by volume of how much your red blood cell contains, and the hemoglobin test measures how much hemoglobin is in your blood. HIV is a virus. It attacks the body's immune system, and if it's untreated, it does progress to AIDS. People don't die from AIDS. People die from the opportunistic infections, which could be a type of pneumonia that they get their immune system is so weakened that they're very susceptible to infections that normally wouldn't kill other individuals if they were exposed to them. According to the CDC, HIV infection humans came from a type of chimpanzee in Central Africa, and the chimpanzee version of the virus is called the simian immunodeficiency virus, or SIV. And they suspect that it was probably passed to humans when humans either hunted chimpanzees for meat and came in contact with their infected blood. Studies show that HIV may have jumped from chimpanzees to humans as far back as the late 1800s. Over decades, HIV slowly spread across Africa and later into other parts of the world. Hearing loss. So HL could stand for hearing loss. And here's a few signs. So for example, nice to meet you is like that, and thank you is like that. So yeah, if you see HOB, it stands for head over head. HR stands for heart rate. How fast is their heart beating in a minute? HS stands for at bedtime. You can remember it by take at hour of sleep. So when you go to sleep. HSV is herpes simplex virus. People often refer to these as cold sores, and the causative factor of cold sores is herpes, right? There's HSV1 and there's HSV2. HSV1 is always thought of as oral herpes. HSV2 is genital herpes. There has been some crossing over. Some people, even though it's less likely to happen, there have been cases of HSV1, which is the oral, in the genital region, and HSV2 in the oral region. They do have preferences though, so that's not likely, but you know, use your imagination to how HSV1 gets to where it gets and HSV2 crosses over to where it got, right? So it is possible, and herpes is very contagious. It's a virus, so there's no cure for it. You can't take an antibiotic and be cured of it, like gonorrhea or chlamydia. So if you have an open cold sore, you don't want to share beverages with someone else, you are able to shed this virus even before you know you're having an outbreak. So always, you know, be mindful if you feel tingling or anything like that. You may want to refrain from kissing your significant other. HTN stands for hypertension. So this patient is hypertensive with a systolic of 220 over 110. Remember that a normal blood pressure is considered less than 120 over 80. Ajax stands for history. So a patient has, and then they write Ajax of asthma. It stands for history of asthma. Thank you so much for watching. If you want the PowerPoint for this video, then make sure you like, subscribe, you turn on the notification bell, and you send an email to nursingwithprofessorb@gmail.com. Send me a screenshot that you liked the video, that you subscribed, and that you turned on the notification bell. Thank you.